What it do, everybody? Appreciate y'all for tuning in to With That Being Said, a hip-hop show where you get points for your hot takes. I am your host, Bougie Brother Sean. Without further ado, I want to go ahead and introduce our special guest. We got Chris Dahl back in the house, and we got Andre Fouquet back in the house. Before we get started, make sure everybody click and subscribe to the channel. All right, let's go ahead and get started with question number one. We are talking about Jadakiss. Now, Jadakiss just released his fifth studio album, Ignatius, in memorial and in memories of his friend Ice Pick. Now my question is to you, Chris Dog, with this project just releasing and after listening to it, does this help Jadakiss get the recognition that he deserves in the game?
Why are we talking about Jadakiss getting recognition in the game? That's nonsense. Why is that even part of this question? Jadakiss is a statesman in the rap game. He put an entire town that nobody gave a fuck about on the map, along with his two fucking comrades, and they go together as the Locks. It's nonsense to act like he still has something to prove. He has absolutely nothing to prove. This album was more of him letting his hair down, in a sense, and just showing some love and recognition to one of his fallen brothers, and I think he did an excellent job doing it. He showed love. He went outside of his box, and he did things that wasn't normal for him on this album. It didn't rock out as a classic Jadakiss album, but it showed that his wide variety of skill sets are to be reckoned with, and that he's an artist that's going to be remembered forever, especially putting New York on the map.
Okay, what about you, 4K? Chris Dawg says he shouldn't even be mentioned about not getting any recognition. Do you think Jadakiss is where he should be at in the game as far as recognition, and what did you think about this album?
Hands down. I mean, he's delivered classics his whole career. He knows how to give you a project. He knows how to give you an album. And Ignatius does not miss as... although this is a passion piece for him, like it's centered around just, you know, what it means, but it was also time for a Jadakiss record, but it was just the passion behind it and being a passion piece that does not disappoint in the catalog of music we've gotten from Jadakiss his whole career. So no, we shouldn't be asking, you know, is he underrated or anything? He's rated right where he's supposed to be. He's one of the OGs. He's one of the godfathers, man. He's somebody who's been through so much with so many people in the industry. He gets the respect that he deserves from his peers. This is definitely a great piece, man, and it's really relatable, man. The record with 2 Chainz, like he was able to reach out and give you a really well put together diverse album that plays well from beginning to end.
Okay, with his top studio albums, with his 5 studio albums, where do you rank this one?
Oh, I think where it should be. I think I would put this probably number 5, just because of where he is in his career and what it, I think kind of what it does, and just it just being a kind of a capsule of his friend, and kind of, you know, so I put it in 5th place. Like, this is where it should be.
Okay, all right, what about you, Chris Dar? Where are you ranking this at?
And really, it's hard for me to mention Jada without mentioning the Locks, but if I do have to go solo discography for him, if it makes the top 5, it does. That's not how I categorize Jadakiss at all. I categorize him in a whole different perspective. It'd be like me. He's just one of those artists that you can't put him in a box. That's not a box he belongs in. He's raw. He's nasty. He's just that guy. He was right on time for when he came, and he's still right on time for right now. And the Pusha T track was fire.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So I'm giving this to 4K. He said this was a passion piece. This is definitely one of those introspective passion pieces. Jadakiss only drops every 4 to 5 years. And for him to maybe harmonize, and then for him to have these Rick Ross beats going in there, this was a priceless, a flawless album for me. And it was long overdue, super long overdue. And then for him honoring Ice Pick, you couldn't beat that. So super shout out to Jadakiss. 4K definitely gets that point. All right, next question. We are going into Lil Yachty. Now, if you haven't seen Lil Yachty's new video, Oprah's bank account, Lil Yachty is dressed up as a Oprah lookalike, and he's just in like several different cross-dressing dresses, and just it's just kind of different. Let's say that at the least. So my question is to you, Christoph. After looking at this Lil Yachty video, Oprah's bank account, do you feel like he kind of went overboard with his creativity, or do you feel like do you feel like the video was just a good video?
I think that creativity-wise, he definitely pushed the limits a little past where I would like to see him go as far as the culture is involved, because when we talk about hip-hop, which he's involved in, you got to speak about the culture. And then we all know when it comes to man putting on dresses, that's where the line is drawn for a real man. So the fact that he did that, the video was funny and so on and so forth. I thought it was hilarious. I thought that him and the baby skit was funny. I thought him and Dre skit was even better. But the dress part was too much for me, the wig and the dress, and I wasn't for it. But was it funny and did I laugh? Yes.
Okay, 4K. Do you feel like it was worth it? Do you feel like he should have took it to that point? Or was it just too much for Lil Yachty in this generation, in these times, for rappers and black men in dresses?
I see it for what it is. I don't think Lil Yachty is out here pushing agendas. Let's just, like, he's not out here pushing it. But what do you want to do if you want attention? This is clickbait. This is a getaway for, hey, I'm about to come out with something. I just need you to look at me. I need you to pay attention to me. So I'm gonna dress up in this dress and I'm gonna get you to click on it, because that's what happened. In this age of social media, you use the fact that it's such a sensitive topic as a way to get attention, to say, hey, look at me, I'm here. And so that's all I think it is. And then you put two of the hottest rappers on that record, you're going to get clicks. You're going to get people to look at it. It served the purpose that it was supposed to serve. But I don't think Lil Yachty's out here pushing any agenda. Is it too much? I mean, yo, man, get out your feelings, man. Yo, you ain't got to dress up in no dress, so chill out.
You are absolutely right, 4K. You definitely get this point, man. I definitely don't think Lil Yachty is that bright to be pushing any type of agendas.
Wow.
For dressing up. And honestly, I think the video was just super creative, super funny. For Drake to even do that, I think Drake would have probably, you know, had been a little more hesitant if it was maybe an agenda pushing type of thing. And then the baby doing it also, man, I just think it was super creative. This kind of reminded me of how we used to look at Martin Lawrence when he used to dress up as a girl on Martin, or when he was dressing up as a woman on Big Mama. You know, it wasn't really like, okay, this is overboard. It was just like, okay, this is funny. So yeah, 4K, you definitely get that, man. Totally, man. I'm not a big Yachty fan, but this video was hilarious. Super kudos to him. All right, next question, we're going into good look, bad look, no look. And we had a surprise release by no other than one of my favorite new rappers, Lil Uzi Vert, and he dropped 2 weeks in a row, but we're only gonna address the Eternal Take album. Yes, he just dropped Eternal Take album. It's probably like maybe 14 to 16 tracks, and it had no features, only one feature, which was R&B, and it was Sid. My question is to you, 4K, good look, bad look, no look, what did you think about the new Lil Uzi Vert album?
I already know I'm not gonna do farewells, so this is a no look for me. Lil Uzi just doesn't resonate with me as an artist. You know what I'm saying? I applaud him. The dude can rap. He can rap his ass off. It was good quality records, but he just doesn't resonate with me. So it was a no look for me, just because he's not an artist that I vibe with, man. It's like, I don't relate to him. So I get the people and I applaud the people that do, but it's a no look for me just because Lil Uzi ain't my kind of guy.
Okay. All right, Christoph, tell me what you think about Eternal Attack, man. Good look, bad look, no look.
This was a good look. This was a good look for me. It was a good look for Lil Uzi Vert, okay? Because I was not a fan of Lil Uzi Vert. Anybody who knows me would tell you that he is not my type of artist. Excuse me. Oh. Corona. He's not my type of artist, but this album, the structure from start to finish, it was solid. He is the up and coming next big thing. I don't know how really to put it, because I got a little baby close right there, but Lil Uzi Vert is right there with him. His lyrical content is solid. He is slick in his his delivery. He says things that make you think. It's very thought-provoking, and he does it his way, which I can't be mad at. The album is very good. Anybody who doesn't like it, I would beg for you to give it a real listen and sit back and hear the content, hear what he's delivering, and give it a second chance, because it's a solid album. It's in my top five for the year so far.
Top five in the year. You know what? I'm definitely agreeing with that. I was not expecting this Lil Uzi album to be that good. You have got to put this in at least two more times, 4K, man. He has some clever, clever bars on here. One of the most clever bars that I'm sure you missed was when he said that my Irish bitch calls me lucky. Like, as clever as this is, growing up in the 80s, listening to that, that's like a wow coming from a 25-year-old artist. So, super kudos to that. Yes, Chris Dog, you get the good look, bad look, no look for the Lil Uzi Vert. Let's go ahead and hit this next question up. Now, we are getting into G-Herbo, one of the young Chicago kings. He just released PTSD album, and that's his fourth studio album. Now, my question is, I'm not sure how big of a fans we are of G-Herbo in this room, but at 25 years old, Chris Dog, do you think G-Herbo can leave a stamp in the game for the next decade?
As far as artists go, I always thought he was decent. He started off really, really, really young. I want to say he started off in his teens, 14, 15 years old. So he's been in the game. He got skin in the game. As far as this album goes, it was super feature heavy, which, you know, is always a negative when it comes to me and albums. I never think an artist should depend on other artists to push his album out there. So it gets a negative from that standpoint. But will he be around? I'm sure he will. He's solid. He has lyrical content. So just not my flavor.
Okay. 4K, after listening to this PTSD, do you think that G-Herbo still has a window going into the 2020-2030 era?
So you know how you do that? And he picked the right records to sample on this album, right? So just the intro, he arguably took Jay-Z's greatest intro from the Dynasty, and he murdered it. I mean, G-Herbo, no hook. He just went through that record and he sliced it up like it was somebody's problem. So from that standpoint, that's how you kick in the door for your next decade. Who ear did he want to grab? He grabbed mine. You know what I'm saying? He with the Feel It In The Air sample. There's certain artists that you can sample, I went back and listened to that Feel It In The Air sample. I've said on some other platforms that I didn't like it. Giving it a fair listen, it really was good. But when he really got me when he took that Jay-Z sample and he actually murdered it. So G-Herbo got his stamp right there for me.
All right, 4K, I think that's a really good point. Just the way G-Herbo is highlighting how good he is on other people's samples tracks. And these are big tracks. You know, the Intuition track that he put out with the Feel It In The Air sample, that was surprisingly better than I expected it. I really expected that to him to miss the mark on that track. Now, don't get me wrong, the intro track with the Jay-Z was fair. I wouldn't say he kicked down the door, but he definitely had the key and opened it up. I would say that, but you know, G-Herbo does have a slight lane within the next 5 years, but I'm scared to say this, but maybe 2025, he's gonna be in the Waka Flocka lane to where he's just, you know, doing content and not necessarily doing music no more and trying to preach to these young kids about what music is really supposed to be about. You definitely get that, 4K. And we're going into our last question, and this is Metro Boomin and 21 Savage. Now, 21 Savage and Metro Boomin just put out something on IG that they're rumored to have the Savage Mode 2 come out very soon, very shortly. Now, after 21 Savage just won his Grammy with J. Cole, my question is to you, Chris Dog. We don't really get to hear a lot about 21 Savage and people don't really bring his name up, but do you think that 21 Savage is underrated or is he getting the credit he deserves?
21 Savage is far from underrated. He's had more than enough publicity to last for years to come. he's solid. He's a solid artist. His music, he gets respect from the greats in the game. They all deal with him. They all don't mind getting on tracks with him. he's good. I mean, he's not great, but he's good. And when he does drop, it's pretty solid. He doesn't, he kind of living his own life. And I like that for artists. I like for them to go on and not be too heavy in the game and not just every single year water us down, because it makes for whack-ass albums. So with him, you know, taking his breaks the right way, I feel like when he does decide to come back, he'll be right where he was before, which is damn good. And I like 21 Savage for being that.
Mm. Okay, 4K, man. What are you thinking about 21 Savage? You think he's underrated?
I was, late to the party. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't until he did the record with J. Cole that I'm like, okay, I actually respect what this guy's, can do. So I'll say that about him, man. And you know, but like he said, he's here for a reason. And the other artists do reach back and or they mess with him. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know if this was just some elaborate plan. Like, he always had those type of records in him, and he just kind of spoon fed us some stuff to get into the game. And then he hit us with this really good content, or if I missed all this really good content from before. But he's not underrated. I think he's rated where he's right where he's supposed to be. As far as like my competitor said, he gets the publicity. Just today, I think he said that he thinks he got coronavirus. So he stay in the news about something, man. So I hope he don't got it, but he stay in the news about something. So hey, man, you gonna click when he drop, you gonna listen.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right. The funny part is, he had a Breakfast Club interview a few years back, and Charlamagne actually was saying the exact things 4K you said, man, that he sprinkled that real good information in there, but he's selling music to his crowd. He's actually way brighter than the music that he's selling to his people. But I will have to give that point to Chris Dogg, because like you said, man, he's a really smart guy. He's bringing quality stuff, and he's smart enough not to overflood and oversaturate the game. It ain't about the money. It ain't about the fame. It's about him. It's about the respect that he's getting in the game, and it's about how he's dropping his music. But with those 2 points, Chris Dogg, you actually just miss it, and 4K gets this win this time. 4K, go ahead and speak your piece in your time to shine.
Yo, man, do me a huge favor, man. Check out Vibes With Me podcast. Click and subscribe right here to With That Being Said. Hey, man, one time for my competitor, Chris Dogg, one time for Bougie Brother Sean. Hey, you already know what it is, man. I love this, man.
Yes, sir. You already know, man. We'll be back next week for another show, man. See y'all then.